Hello everyone, welcome back in science class. How are you all? Hope so you all are doing well, right? Now today we are going to start new chapter 4, Chotu's house. Let's see. Now here we can see some images of Chotu's house, right? Chotu came to Ahmedabad for the first time. So in this story, the main character is Chotu, and he has come to Ahmedabad first time. Let's decide that what all image is showing, right? So in first image, we can see a busy road, and this boy over here means Chotu, confusingly looking at the road, right? We can see that. Now in second image, we can see that it is raining as well there, and two more children along with Chotu. Now in third image, we can see that Chotu is having rest in this pipe, means Chotu's house, right? Now in fourth image, we can see that Chotu is preparing something to eat because he is hungry now, right? Now here two more images are given. Let's see what they actually saying. So in fifth image, we can see that again the same image as the first one, Chotu see a busy road, right? And in sixth image, we can see he is talking to his friend, right? So these are all about the images. Let's move ahead. Let's see what actually happening here. Study the pictures carefully and answer the following. So first question is, what did Chotu think when he looked at the pipe? So basically Chotu has come to Ahmedabad for the first time. He has no place to stay in the Ahmedabad. When Chotu saw the pipe, he thought that the pipe is very good place for him to stay because he would not have to pay any rent for staying there, right? So no one would send him away from there. The pipe would protect him from strong winds, rain, cold and heat, right? Now second question is, how did Chotu use the pipe? So Chotu used the pipe as his home. We can see in images, right? He must have slept in the pipe, cooked his food outside and sat around it for a chat with his friends, right? We can see in the images. Now in third question, into which parts did Chotu divide the pipe and its surrounding area? So Chotu divided the pipe and its surrounding area into these parts: a place for cooking, sleeping, for drying clothes, for storing water, for guests and friends. Okay. Now, in fourth question, in which part of this house would Chotu like to spend most of his time? So we can see already Chotu would like to spend most of his time in the place kept for guests and friends. Okay. Now in fifth question, why do you think Chotu invited Monu to live with him in the pipe? So just like Chotu, Monu has also come to Ahmedabad for the first time, and he too has no place to stay. Moreover, Chotu wanted a friend to stay with him. Therefore, Chotu invited Monu to live with him in the pipe. Right. Now in last and sixth question, how will you make a house in pipe if you wear chotu? If I wear chotu, I will arrange curtains around the pipe to protect it and me from dust, heat, etc. and then live in it. Right. Now we learn about our house. A house is constructed with bricks, sand, stones, cement, water, etc. Right? Wood and iron are also used in construction. Once a house is ready, a family lives in it, so it becomes a home. Our home protects us from cold, heat, rain, and wind. Right? We can see in this picture. We use each part of the house in various ways. For example, as our drawing room, as our bedroom, kitchen, as our study room, as a bathroom, and lavatories. Now, come on this page. Draw a picture of your house in your notebook and color it. So, you have to draw a house and in your notebook and color this picture. Okay. This activity, do it by yourself. Now move ahead. Here two questions are given. Who all live with you in your house? So basically in your house, father, mother, brother, uncle, aunt, grandfather and grandmother live, right? So you have to write down here. Father, mother, brother, uncle, aunt, grandfather and grandmother. Now in second question, Chotu divided the pipe into different parts, right? The different parts of your house. So in our house, living room, bedroom, study room, kitchen, bathroom and lavatories are present, right? Now here more three questions are given. First is, how much time in a day do you spend in each part of your house? So what we need to do is, we need to tell that how much time in a day do we spend in each part of our house. So I can say that around drawing room 2 hours, in kitchen 2 hours, bedroom 8 hours, study room 3 hours, right? Bathroom and lavatories 1/2 hour. So you also tell me later. Now second question is there any part of your house where a particular member of your family spends more time? So basically yes, my grandparents spend more time in the drawing room and my mother spends more time in the kitchen. Now in third question is there any part of your house where a particular family member never goes or goes for a short time? So yes, my grandfather and father do not like to go into the kitchen, right? So here you must have seen that some animals also live with us in our house. Some of these animals live with us because we want them to, while some are uninvited. So those animals which we keep with us, it's our choice, right? It's known as pet animals because we keep them as our pets and we love keeping them together, while some of the animals are uninvited also, right? So here we are done with all the three questions now. I hope you all are understood this video. Bye bye everyone.